Hello guys, welcome to the third part of those tutorials, those set of tutorials. In this tutorial, I will explain to you how you can change views. On the last tutorial, I have explained to you how you can navigate on the viewport using the mouse. I have also explained to you how work with those buttons over here that you can navigate by clicking on them. Without the use of only the mouse, you have used this gizmo to rotate, this magnifying glass to zoom in or zoom out, this hand to panning, and but I haven't explained to you those two. This one goes to the camera. Basically, what we are seeing now is where the camera is pointing at, okay? And this one changes between user perspective and orthographic. User perspective is the view that comes by default. As you can see, those lines on the grid are pointing to one single point. Okay? And but if you click here, you can use user orthographic. Those grid views are parallel to each other. It is not realistic, but it can be useful in some situations. In this tutorial, I will explain to you how you can change views. So this is the user perspective. If you want to change views, you can use this gizmo over here and clicking on the axis, top, left, bottom, right. Okay, but you can also use the numpad. It is quicker, and I surely advise you to memorize this. If you press 1, you go to front view. If you press Control plus 1, you go to back. If you press 3, you go to right. If you press Control 3, you go to left. If you press 7, you go to top, and if you press Control 7, you go to the bottom. If you don't have a numpad on your keyboard, it's easy to bypass that. Just go to your preferences menu over here, and in the input tab, make sure that you emulate numpad. After that, you can use the normal regular numbers on your keyboard to emulate the numpad. Okay? I think that is it. Just one more thing. If you want to change between perspective and orthographic view, you can press on number 5 also. You can use this icon over here, or you can press on number 5. In some situations, some people may call the orthographic view an isometric view. That is basically the same. So if someone have called this an isometric view, you already know that is what in Blender is called an orthographic view. Thanks a lot for watching. That's another part, an easy one. I hope to see you all in the next tutorial. If you like this, please subscribe my channel.